In this video, we're going to cover how to construct a bar graph. A bar graph uses vertical or horizontal bars whose lengths represent the frequencies of data, and this data is often qualitative or categorical. For instance, you could construct a bar graph for the data in this table, the number of monthly shoe sales for each model of a certain shoe company. Bar graphs are easy to construct, as in our example, you simply draw an X and Y axis, label the X axis as shoe models, and write in the different models of shoes at equal distances from one another on the X axis. Label the Y axis units sold. Next, from the table, find the highest value in the table, 67. Round up to 70, and mark that somewhere near the top of the Y axis. Then make 6 more marks of equal distances going down the Y axis, marking them 60, 50, and so on down to 10. Next, you would draw in the bar for the first shoe model, Sapphire, which had 22 sales. Then draw in the next bar for the Weekender shoe, which goes up to 67. If you're drawing these in by hand, make sure that the bars are the same width, or at least within reason. Next, we'll continue this process for the 3 remaining shoes. As I said earlier in this video, you could make this same bar graph in a horizontal manner, as you see here. Another bar graph that is often used in statistics is a compound bar graph. A compound bar graph is used to compare data for 2 or more groups. This bar graph shows, over a 4-year span, the salaries of a pro football team spent on defensive players and offensive players. Alright my friends, hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here!